Hello, hi, welcome to Aftv. Today with me I have Mr. Jeffrey Ekato. Mr. Jeffrey Ekato, welcome to Aftv.
Thank you very much.
Can you please introduce yourself to our viewers?
My name is Jeffrey Ekato from Edo State, Nigeria. I came to Netherlands since 1999. I started to set up a business in 2004. I started with a night shop. In that same year, it didn't go well, let me say, because of something happened along the line. Shop was ready, and it was almost about 3 days before we start opening. Somebody went there at the middle of the night and set the shop ablaze.
Oh my God!
I put my faith together, and I tried to fight the case through the insurance and police, but it couldn't help. They said there's nothing they can do for me, and the insurance said they would never pay nothing. So I lose totally from that first experience.
Yeah.
So, well, it didn't stop me not to continue my dream, because when I came here, I know that I want to do, only want to do something right from my childhood. My business is part of my life, daily activities. You know, I started it when I was nine years old with my mother in the market and so on. So I feel that I can't do anything apart from business, but it's the only thing that I know that I can do. So that one gone by, I didn't succeed from it. And I tried to go further, but people were telling me, it's in Holland, it's very difficult. It's a place that
People always say it's difficult.
You won't succeed in anything you are doing because of racism, because of the tax problem, because of so many kind of things they talk about when it comes to investing in Holland. So for me, I see that it's not something that you don't just listen to people and say, oh, the conclusion is already there. I'm not going to do it because somebody said this, or somebody said that, somebody said that. I move on, and I try to forget about what happened those period of time.
Oh, that's nice.
I walk over it again and try to meet family members. My mother helped me, my father did the same thing, and I borrowed some money from them and sold some of my landed property back home to regain myself back to the business. Then I started up a new shop. It was a very small shop. I started from there again. And people who saw me doing it, they think, what is this guy up to? You lost one and you started another one again. To me, it was something that I want to do. I don't want to sit indoor and
so you are more of like an old soldier never
die. You know what I mean? So started complaining about this, about this, how, you know, so for me, I just want to keep on doing something. So I started from that small shop, and that year it was really going good, because the country was really booming then, because there were a lot of African people, and things were going fine. So the shop become too small for me in a short period of time, after 2 years of that same small shop. Then from there, I got a bigger place. So I negotiated with the owner of the place, and the man said, okay, good. You can take the shop from me and put your things inside. So then we moved to another bigger shop where my new beauty supply is situated. Then it was in late summer of 2010. But inside my business that I'm doing, I was still organizing party. You know, once in every month, I make something like African night. where people could come,
can come and have,
you know,
fun.
Have fun.
Yes.
Because the most problem we are having here then is that we don't have a place of Africa we call our own.
Exactly.
A place where you can go and sit and meet with your brothers and sisters and share happiness together.
Yes.
You know, so most people do come to my shop then and they started drinking there. You see a lot of noise. You know, sometimes I even get control with police. They say, yeah, this place is not a bar. It's not a restaurant. It's just a hair shop and a cosmetic shop. So I said, okay, but I can't do anything because they are my people. I can't just push them away.
No.
But they said, you have to look. I said, okay, good. But the thing were not coming to my mind. It was not easy for me to open a nightclub or a cafe. So I said, okay, good. If I could get a place where I bring my people, where they can sit down and have their fun, I said, okay, good. I thought of it, and I pulled the decision with my wife, and told me, yeah, that, you know, we have one already, so how are we going to run the two places together? I said, okay. I said, God is in control.
Yes.
I said, well, we started it, and we see how to go. I said, yeah, that people have business empire all over the world. I said, they are not even there, but people run it for them. I said, okay, let's see what God will do in our life and see. So I organized the party. It was Nigeria Independence. Was it that very day? I can still remember.
Okay.
The owner of the place saw how massively the crowd was.
Yes.
He was very happy because he have never sold that kind
of. Already they are like kind of like they are being stopped, like they don't have a place,
to go
and hang out,
you know?
And now here comes the party, so of course you will have a lot of bunch of people, I guess.
Yes, that day was a very massive crowd.
Yes.
And he really make a lot of sense that night. And after the party, he called me personally and thanked me for what I've done for him.
Yeah.
And I said, okay, good. After that party went, so he called me again. I said, okay, if I can be able to make another party again here, I said, okay, I will try to help you out to see how we can pull crowd again. So we did the second one, and it was successful as well. Then he was telling me that he's trying to go out of the business. If I know anybody who want to buy a club or a cafe, I mean, so, okay. This is just a plan I was just trying to make some a few weeks ago. I said, okay, then I take a second thought of it. I said, okay, good. If it's worth investing for, let me try and see
how it's going to come out.
I make a deal with him.
Yeah.
In that same 2010, I said, okay. The only option I will do is that I will run it for a year before we go into contract for anything.
Mm-hmm.
So, of which he agreed. So, I paid the rent, I paid the electricity bill, I paid the tax, and I paid the workers and everything that we run here.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did it for a good 1 year, there was no problem. But we do have problem, you know, when people got drunk, they become something else.
Exactly, because I was wanting to ask you, like, how do you deal with abusive drunk customers sometimes? Because since you happen to be like this person who has the heart to like help African people to have a place to hang out and have fun, of course you might come across people like, you know, when they are drunk and you know, and all the situation. How do you tackle it, like?
Yeah, but yes. So that is a very difficult issue to handle when it comes to alcohol abusers. So most people drink, they become like child. So you need to help them to stand up and sit down. And most people drink, then they start fighting, you know. And that is, in Holland, it's very, very stressful for the owner of the cafe or
the cafe,
club,
yes.
You know. So if something happened here, everything that happened here is on my own responsibility.
Exactly.
You know, so it doesn't matter, 100 meters away from here, if anything happened, I'm responsible for it because I invited them to come.
Yeah.
You know, so but I try to talk to them as one people, as family, and most of them do listen to me. They just say, okay, we have a problem. So I call both of them together. Sometimes we sit down and we talk over it, ask them, okay, shake each other and let this problem not start here anymore.
Yeah.
And I try to introduce, listen, the thing is not that when you come here to fight, that you go home is peace. For me, I still need to go to police station to answer more questions and to tell them, listen, this was not my intention. Yeah. It's somebody who came from, you know, so many things. So I try to make sure I raise it very good so that we have a long term of friendly business.
Okay,
so,
because I also thinking like, what other challenges did you also come through in this aspect, like you, the owner, and apart from like people being a drunker, and what other challenges do you face also?
There are a lot of challenges when it comes to club business in Holland. I don't know if other countries is like that, but this.
Because I know in Nigeria, if you want to open a club, you just open a club and you don't pay so much, and people keep coming and having fun and no so much problem like here.
I've been to so many countries.
Yes,
I've been out and see, ask questions on the, how they run clubs, how the rules have been. So most people tell me how it's been issues there, and the rules have been. It's tough for them that compared to the one of in Holland. Yeah. So, but I come to see, I say, okay, but sometimes I don't blame because you see, like I said, when somebody drunk, is living in another world.
It's true.
You know, it's not. You see, everybody we don't have the same blood.
Yeah.
So the thing that your own blood might be good in alcohol, not more lighter. Yes. The other one maybe. So so most people when they drink at least one or two can of Heineken, they become sick. But there are people who drink a bottle of Remy Martin, Hennessy, and they still strong.
Yes.
You know. So the thing is that I try to argue it out with the police and the government. So they couldn't. Listen, that is the rule. So the most challenging that we face that is police problem.
Yeah,
it's one of those biggest problems we have here.
Yes.
You know, they keep on threatening you and you know telling you if something happens, we close you down. And so it's like
God.
when I'm running with you throughout the night, my mind is just as oh my God, let people don't fight today. Let this not happen today. Let this not happen today.
Yes.
You know? So, but when it comes to Horeca, cafe business or clubbing business in Holland, I think the police, they are not really helpful. Because they make these rules very, very hard.
Very strict.
So it's something that, if somebody come, like there was some time ago, there was some, group of guys.
Yeah.
They were not from my place.
Yes.
They were not from my club.
Yes.
So they were coming from somewhere else. Mm. We already closed down there. So we heard them fighting some at my close to my neighbor's place.
Yes.
So my security went out and checked what was happening. Mm. Saw that there were a group of guys who were coming from. So the body are blacks.
Yeah.
So they started fighting over there in the
group. Oh my God.
You know, so the police came and asked who had said they are not my client. But to them, because these guys are black people, so they believe that the police.
Yeah, because of course you
so
are
they call
the
me
only
and
owner of
the
black
black club.
Black club around.
And
so
I told them
there might be your property.
Yes, I said there might be fights everywhere. It doesn't mean that every black man who live from anywhere come and fight them is my client.
Yes, you know?
The rules are too harsh on
too
us.
Harsh. Well,
you know, so those are most of the biggest challenges we face. Otherwise, the things are very bad.
That is exactly kind of like, I must say, hectic for you
very,
for the
very
moment.
Hectic.
But I also want to ask you about like, what other, you know, what do you enjoy the most part of, you know, being this, being the owner of this club.
What I enjoy most in this business is, you see, me seeing people happy alone.
Yeah.
Is what I enjoy most in this, because there are a lot of people I have seen that passing through difficult stress.
Exactly.
You know, sometimes when they come here, you see that person laughing again.
Oh my God,
you
are seriously a man of the people. Somebody who has a
heart
for people.
It gives you joy.
Yes.
You know, I have, some time ago, somebody came here and said he have never, he have been in this country for the past 6 years. The man was from Guinea.
Yeah.
Came from Guinea. So I think a friend of him introduced me to him and said, yeah, this is the owner of the place. And the man was looking at, I didn't know him, the man was just spotting at me. Mm-hmm. So I was working busy, you know, making peace all over. The place was really jam-packed that day. So I saw somebody tap me on my shoulder and called me. He said, "Fam, you know this place?" I said, "Yes." You know, he doesn't speak good English.
Yeah.
And the man held my two hands. And in the middle of the club, he started praying. You know, so I was, nah. So later the man told me, he said, if I'm not mistaken, man is above 50 of age. His age should be. So he said the reason why he's doing this, he said, because he have been here for the past 6 years, and he have been so many places in the city. He wanted to go in to just have fun, but they wouldn't allow him.
Oh my God!
You know, they said, yeah, it is. You are not allowed to come in. He asked why he's not allowed to come in, and there is no reason for that. So, but by him coming to this place today and see how the crowd, how people were happy, and the kind of music he was hearing, you know, he feel at home. He'd never seen it before.
Yes.
You know, so he, at least with that day, I know that I'm doing something for people. Mm-hmm. But we have so many events going on here,
okay,
clubbing, you know.
Okay.
We have a student meeting here sometimes.
Okay.
We have students from Erasmus University.
Okay.
They come here sometimes, they book for a day, and they want to have a student meeting here.
Okay.
And we have
birthday party also.
Sometimes, children party, and we have marriage party as well.
Okay.
So we have so many events going on here, like business meeting.
Okay.
So we have a couple of things that are going on here, not only really just clubbing. You really dedicate yourself.
Yes.
Into, the most thing I'll ever tell people, when you like what you are doing, you never get tired of it.
Yes, it's true.
You understand what I mean? So the thing that I love what I'm doing, when I get up in the morning, you know, that I'm joining the crowd that is going somewhere, that is going to work.
Yeah.
I don't mind if I have to work 24 hours a day.
Yes.
Even sometimes I even think, oh, why God don't make it at least 26 hours?
Oh.
Add more 2 hours so that I can have more time to work.
You
more.
Will leave so, love for us in the name of God. Amen.
The thing is that it's very hectic.
Yes.
By combining the two business together, and not only that, the administrative sector of it is was the most difficult part in this business. You know,
that's everything in Netherlands, I guess, is about paperwork and stuff like that. Yes.
But we thank God that we have the power and
in
the opportunity to do it.
Yes.
So for me, it's I just try to live in it.
Okay.
And
like the beauty, the beauty shop that you're, is it anything concerning hairs, like makeups, all this cosmetic stuff for ladies, and is there anything you want to,
like the beauty shop, everything to make a woman beautiful.
Oh my God, I'm coming there.
We have it. You know, you see, it's, I set up the beauty shop, it's not just because, for women alone, or it's just because during that time there was no even Nigeria shop in Rotterdam.
Yes.
I think I was the first Nigeria shop to be open here, but we have the Ghanaian shop and
right.
So, but I decided to come with a really typical Nigeria food store. To that is I have been doing such. How do I say it? Organizing events for young Nigerian youths. We did it twice already.
Okay.
I try to advise them. Listen, we come to a foreign land. It's not our country, and we must not look. Oh, it's not possible. Mm-hmm. That's something that impossible. Let we take it out of our
record.
Everything is possible.
Exactly.
You know what you want to do,
yeah,
you try and do it.
Exactly.
But never you said it's not possible.
Yeah.
So I try to give them lecture and advise them. Mm-hmm. Listen, our brothers have come here, yeah, long ago.
Yes.
So they could not do what we are doing in this, mm-hmm, new generation. So, mm-hmm, at least we need to tell them that, listen, this thing can be done. We have our rights.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I mean? If you have a Dutch nationality, you are equal to exactly like the Dutch people.
Exactly.
You understand? You don't need to even go and start dragging their own job from them. Mm-hmm. You can create your own job.
Yes.
You see, I tell most people, listen, you be very, very careful for what you pray for.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I mean?
Yeah.
And most people, they say, oh, the name of Dutch passport, I get it. I guess, okay, but when you have it, what do you want to do?
Exactly.
You stay back in Aftv.
Mm-mm.
You understand? We said we have economic problem in Africa.
Yeah.
There is no job opportunities.
Yes.
They could not, our government could not provide a job for us. But we come to a country where you know that you can expand, mm, that you can do things. You have a free liberty.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
So why can't you just get up and do something?
Mm.
Just continue to try. Even if it doesn't go, well, continue to try.
Yeah.
But maybe one day it will just click.
That is nice. Thank you very much, Mr. Jeff Echato. In your free days, do you have time to go and have fun on your own? Like, what are your hobbies? What do you like to do when you are free?
It's a very difficult time for me to create time for outing. Or because,
wow,
most of the time, daytime like this, I'm in the beauty shop.
Mm.
But I have people working for me there,
mm,
but I cannot just leave them just like that. And since we are opening every evening,
yes,
in me and you,
mm,
so I can't even go far beyond the border. So normally I just walk around Rotterdam here, oh, sometimes. So I almost don't have time to go to other place and enjoy. So I dedicate myself in my business here
and for your people
and for my family.
Yes.
So the time I have,
yes,
I have to go to somewhere,
yes,
to party. So I better keep that time to my children and my wife because they need that time most. So when I leave them, they are the only happiness that I have apart from my job. Because sometimes I even just, oh, I don't have much time for this. For these people, so I try to create time for them.
Yes.
So if I have any time, I better spend it with them than going somewhere else to.
Exactly. You know, exactly.
So that is
okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Jeff, I heard like you are going to change the name of Me and You. Don't you think like changing the name will affect your business, because people only know Me and You, and you know it's the one and only club in Rotterdam. Have you ever thought about that, and why do you want to change the name?
Yeah, right about that. I've thought of it so many times,
okay,
about the name, but there is this thing in my mind that I always want to do.
Okay.
I really want to dedicate this club to Africa.
Beautiful.
So that is the main reason why I'm changing the name. So, and the new name is Club d'Afrique.
Oh, beautiful.
So that would be
Club
the new
d'Afrique
name. So everybody out there, wherever you are, so Africa, you know that you have a place, you call your own place. So I really make it a house of Africa. And so that's the main reason why. But I know it should be a kind of, oh, there's no me and you anymore, but it will still remain.
Exactly, the same, I me think and people you would love
and,
it.
And most of our clients, I think they will help us to share the news around and that the place is still on. And we just embrace our old African names, and that is why.
Thank you very much. Do you have anything to say to our viewers out there, like generally, also anything else you have?
Viewers? I thank you very much for supporting me all this while, and I pray that God will grant you people good health and prosperity.
Amen.
And don't forget to still keep on coming. Help me share this news around Club Me and You, Club Afrique, and let's have our own ground here in Netherlands.
Well, Mr. Jeff, do you have anything to tell our viewers out there, like generally?
Yes, of course. Like we have events coming up in December, but the whole of December is it's a party month, and moreover we organized the first ever Benin Igwe Festival, which is coming up on the 23rd of December. So we try to bring it in Me and You. It has never happened here. People have never heard of it. So we try to bring it to light for our people out there to come and experience the great Igwe Festival with in Club Me and You. And there are so many, also like Christmas party, New Year Eve party, and so on and so forth.
Wow.
Thank you very much. And,
well, thank you very much for coming to AFTV. And yeah. I really appreciate
you. You don't say what I don't ask.
Thank you.
I'm in love. Are you in love? Mama, you done make me fall in love. Fall in love. Fall in love. We still have married because you done make me fall in love. Fall in love. Sweet potato, I wanna tell you my mind, wanna tell you my mind, oh. I know understand, oh. Cause I don't see where I wear, but them say love is blind, oh. You see us, you get so. You are the love of my life, you are the love of my life, oh. I cannot deny, oh. I wanna make you my wife, wanna make you my wife, oh. See, I never thought that I would find someone like you. That would capture my heart and there's nothing I can do. I used to brag to my friends that I'd always I set my eyes on you. Mama, you done make me fall in love.